Joining us on the line now is Attorney Manuelito Luna, is the lawyer of one of the complainants, as I mentioned, against Chairman Bautista. Good morning, Attorney Luna.
Good morning, Christian, and to your televiewers.
First, sir, what's the logic behind this? The Comelec chairman already announced that he was resigning effective at the end of the year, and still Congress, voting in plenary, the House of Representatives, still decided to impeach him. What's the rhyme or reason behind this?
Well, I can only sense that he probably had inside information that the plenary would reverse the decision of the Committee on Justice, junking the impeachment complaint of former Congressman Paras and Attorney Topacio. And so he tried to preempt the action of the plenary. And so because his resignation was not irrevocable and immediate, because he said that it will take effect only on December 31. So the House thought that he was trying to play games with them. So that's the reason for the overwhelming vote of the plenary to reverse the dismissal made by the Committee on Justice based on their finding that the complaint was insufficient in form.
So in short, you don't trust the Comelec chairman that he would indeed step down at the end of the year. But isn't this just a waste of resources, considering everything that's on the plate of the Senate now and also of the House of Representatives? You're going to conduct an impeachment trial against the Comelec chairman about 2 months, a little over 2 months before he actually steps down based on his resignation letter.
Alam mo, Christian, every minute counts. So he's in public service. He has not yet resigned, actually, because the date that the resignation would take effect would only be on December 31. And so the Congress has a constitutional duty, especially the Senate now, after the plenary has reversed the House Committee on Justice. It has to hear the case. This is a constitutional duty, and this cannot be prevented, considering that the resignation is not really irrevocable and immediate. And so this is the fault of the chairman of the Comelec for styling his letter of resignation that way. He should have made it irrevocable and immediate.
How do you respond to the, because you also have on the other line via Skype the brother of Chairman Bautista. He said that this vote by the House of Representatives to impeach his brother was only meant to humiliate the Comelec chairman.
Well, you cannot prevent the members of the House, the representatives of the people, from doing their constitutional duty. This is provided for in their rules and in the Constitution. So this is actually what the law of the land wanted the House to do. They have to make a decision. It, no matter how painful it is, it may have an impact on the respondent, Chairman Bautista. I know that this is painful for him, but the House has to do its work. We cannot prevent the House. Not even the complainant could have prevented the House from acting the way they did.
Finally, Attorney Luna, pardon me for this question, but a lot of people might be wondering, is there a grand scheme behind all these impeachment complaints filed against, for example, Chairman Bautista, and of course the upcoming complaint to be filed against the Ombudsman and the existing complaint against the Chief Justice? Is there really a grand plan here? And of course, others have noticed that there's always this trace or signature of the Volunteers Against Crime and Corruption in each of these complaints, considering its closeness with the President.
I don't think there is such a plan. This is just it is. People are now exercising their rights, their governance, believing in what the President, the administration has made it clear right from the start that it wanted to rid the government of corruption and to rid streets of the drug menace and criminality. So this is just a coincidence that some officials whom the complainants feel have not been up to task and have betrayed the public trust or culpably violated the Constitution, have to be made accountable. And that's the right of the people. Remember, in impeachment, the real stakeholders are the people.
Okay. Thank you very much for joining us this morning, Attorney Manuelito Luna.
Salamat, Christian.
Okay, salamat po. We'll get back to Dr. Martin Bautista. Still joins us via Skype from Oklahoma. Dr. Bautista, I'm not sure whether you heard what Attorney Manuelito Luna said a few minutes ago. He said that your brother should have tendered an irrevocable resignation. And his claim was that the chairman was just trying to play games with the congressman or with the process. Your response to this?
He actually did tender an irrevocable resignation effective 12/31/2017 to give the president enough time to pick a successor to his office. And that's exactly my point. He was willing to face justice, to face the music after he stepped down January 1. But they did not even give him that 30 days, which is okay. As I said, now we will be forced to show the truth. And all this hypocrisy about the people wanting to know the truth. Christian, keep in mind, the Committee on Justice had to rule that this impeachment complaint was defective because we don't even know what bank books they're talking about, what checking accounts that they're talking about. We have not been given the opportunity to examine whatever these documents are. Hindi po namin alam kung lahat po ito talaga fabrication lang. But at the same time, we have done our homework and we can account for every peso, just as I told you last August. We can account for everything. No.
We were all prepared to show you guys na wala pong ninakaw dito. Pero pati ngayon, they want Congress all of a sudden to burden the Senate with another responsibility that is going to be resolved anyway by the proper authorities, namely the NBI, the Ombudsman, the BIR, and all the other investigative units of our country.
Now, how difficult was the decision to finally step down as far as your brother was concerned, considering that he would lose his immunity?
Yes, but he was prepared to lose his immunity by January 1. I mean, he was prepared to do that, Christian, but the overwhelming need for his sons to have a responsible parent was just there. I mean, we could see it. I mean, he's under so much stress right now, keeping his family together. And in the scheme of things, while we love our country, we love Comelec, we love it, we have to take care of our family first. And that came to that point. I mean, and it would have been good, and it would have been opportune for everybody else if we just gave my brother the time to tie all loose ends and then let go. And he was prepared to face it, as I said. Wala po kami takot, wala po siyang tinatago.
Now, if I may ask Dr. Bautista, what was the last straw, really, as far as your brother was concerned, before he decided to step down? You mentioned these personal issues. He continues to stay under the same roof with his wife and, of course, their children. What was the last straw, as far as you're concerned? Was there a specific incident that happened?
Last straw, who kasi, when the Committee on Justice ruled by 26-2 yata on the second time, and then they kept on making press statements that we are undeterred, kahapulin namin kayo, whatever happens, not allowing time for healing and for justice to be served.
Pero yun, yung mga anak, yung mga bata, nakikita naman po nila ito lahat nasa dario, nasa internet, nasa Facebook. All these bloggers are putting in their opinion. Halos kalahati naman ng mga opinion na yun, hindi naman po totoo. Lahat po kami nadadamay po dito. And it was about time that we just kept quiet. And we have kept quiet. Ever since I spoke to you in August, I have kept quiet. I have tried to reach out to my sister-in-law, pero wala po talaga. My family has tried hard to reach out.
Pero wala. I mean, we have tried to show that everything can be accounted for,
but she has never given us the courtesy nor the opportunity
to show our side. And so we are left with nothing. I mean, we have no options left at this point.
Dr. Bautista, was your brother also worried or concerned that he might be humiliated or embarrassed in the impeachment trial? That's why he also decided to finally step down ahead of that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, kung ang kapatid ko lang, kung ako nga lang at ang kapatid ko, kaya po namin yun. Pero yung aking nanay na 84, na nakaka-stroke na alam po, ang tatay ko po 87, lahat po ito madadamay. Yung nanay ni Tisha, madadamay. Yung
stepfather ni Tisha, madadamay. Lahat po ito madadamay. Hindi lang po namin iniisip ang sarili namin. Pero sinabi ko sa kapatid ko, kung kinakailangan kumarap kami sa Senate Impeachment Body, kami lang dalawa, gagawin ko po yung uuwi ako dyan para lang ipakita sa mga senador po natin na wala pong pinakaw aking kapatid. If we have to do it that way, publicly, hindi po kami kukuha ng expert, wala po kami kukunin, papakita lang namin ang katotohanan. Impeach us, wala kami
magagawa doon. But we will show finally, the public na wala po kami ninakaw.
Okay, finally, Dr. Bautista, you kept talking about the idea that all these allegations of hidden wealth or ill-gotten wealth have been fully, this money, these resources have been fully accounted for. How much are we talking about here? Because based on the allegations by Patricia Bautista, this allegedly unexplained wealth amounts to close to 1 billion pesos. Based on your computation, based on your accounting, how much?
Christian, it is significantly less. Yung kanilang binabato na 1.2 billion, hindi po totoo yun. And I can tell this to you, all the way from Oklahoma, na hindi po totoo yun. It is significantly less. Yung 35 passbooks is patently false.
It's a lie. Yung account sa Hong Kong and Shanghai Bank is a lie. And lahat kalokohan po dito. Pero lahat po tayo are, we have no choice except to show you the truth once and for all. In a humiliating impeachment political process that's not meant to show the truth, but rather to actually destroy people.
Wait, so when you mentioned significantly less in terms of the amount, how much are we talking about here?
Alam niyo po, Christian, alam niyo, since this will be adjudicated shortly, I will refrain from making any other comments at this point, but I want to assure you and the public that it is not 1.2 billion pesos.
Okay. On that note, thank you very much for joining us this morning, Dr. Martin Bautista, via Skype from Oklahoma.